Welcome to my channel, Programming with Nitin. Today, I am going to explain the topic Self-Management Skills, which is the unit number 2 of the Employability Skill Part A, IT 402 subject, class 9. The topics of the unit are Introduction, Session 1, Introduction to Self-Management, Session 2, Strength and Weakness Analysis, Session 3, Self-Confidence, Session 4, Positive Thinking, Session 5, Personal Hygiene, Session 6, Grooming. So let's start with introduction. Self-management, which is also referred to as self-control or self-regulation. It is the ability to regulate one's emotions, thoughts and behavior effectively in different situations. This includes motivating oneself and setting and working towards personal and academic goals. Students with strong self-management skills are able to do different activities effectively, including managing their timelines, focusing on their tasks, cooperating with others in school and at home, and perform better in their studies. It helps in future studies, work and life. So basically, self-management is related to self-control and self-regulation, by which you can good in your work, in your life, in your studies, and also you can able to working towards your goal related to academics or the social life goals, whatever. And you will also able to control your emotions if you are self-managing yourself. Okay. So now session 1, Introduction to Self-Management. Self-management involves understanding yourself, understanding what your interests and abilities are, having a positive attitude and grooming yourself in order to develop self-confidence. If you control your spirit, mind, body, emotions, you are self-managing yourself. You can do anything in world. This type of self-motivation, if you have, then you are self-managing yourself. Self-management can also help in developing good habits, overcoming bad habits, reaching your goals, overcoming challenges and difficulties. Example, after writing an exam, have you ever felt that you should have studied more? Do you think that you could manage your hobbies, interests and studies better if you could manage your time well? This type of thoughts, if you are thinking in your life, so you are towards the self-managing yourself. Being able to manage yourself helps you to avoid stress and provides opportunities to get involved in fun activities. If you are able to manage yourself, you are stress-free, you take the opportunities to involve yourself in fun activities and in work also. Self-management skills include the following things like self-awareness, self-control, self-confidence, problem-solving, self-motivation, personal hygiene and grooming, positive thinking, teamwork, time management, goal setting. These are the basic things of self-management skills that if you are already doing in your life, you will managing yourself properly. And if you are not doing this, you are not managing yourself properly. Session 2, Strength and Weakness Analysis. We will discuss this with an example. Have you ever wondered why you get good marks in one subject and not so good in another subject? Knowing what you do well or not so well will help you in converting your weakness. If you are thinking this type of things by yourself, this will help to know what you do well or not so well. It will converting your weakness into strength and strength into an exceptional performance. The strength and weakness analysis helps you in this process. Strength and weakness analysis begins with knowing yourself first. You have to know about yourself that what is your strength and what is your weakness. Okay. knowing yourself. What we mean by knowing yourself? It means understanding who you are, what you like, what you do not like, what are your beliefs, what are your opinions, what is your background, what you do well and what you do not do well. It is important to know who you are, because only then can you measure your strengths and weakness. In figure, all the questions which we have to ask ourselves is written. Who am I? What are my values? What are my dislikes? What are my beliefs? What are my likes, opinions, background? These are the basic terms by which you can know yourself. Okay. Strength and weakness. Like in this picture, strengths are what we do well and are good at. Everyone has some strengths. In which area we are good is, that is our strength. Weakness, areas of improvement or what we do not do well and are not good at. The areas of improvement on which we have to work ourselves and we are not good at, that are the weaknesses. Everyone has some weaknesses. So when we know our weakness and we are working on the weakness, then it becomes in the path of achieving the strength. Okay. Strength and weakness analysis. Being self-aware or understanding who am I means looking outside usual characteristics such as our name, qualifications and the relationship we have with others. It actually means knowing our inner strengths, hidden talents, skills and even weaknesses. Let us look at what could be our strength and weakness. Understanding ourselves, we can know what we can and cannot do. Based on that information, we can plan what and how we can improve ourselves. By improving, we will feel confident about ourselves. Okay. So by this figure, you can convert your weaknesses in your strength by analyzing your weaknesses. Okay. Example of strength and weakness. Example of strength. I am good at understanding other people's emotion. I am confident in dealing with strangers while keeping myself safe from any harm. I help my parents in household things. I play cricket very well. Examples of weakness. I am unable to resist junk food when my friends suggest. I would like to learn more about computers. These are the sample or examples of strength and weakness. Identifying strength and weakness. Identifying strengths. Take time off to think about what you do well. Thinking of anything that you are always good at. Think about what others appreciate about you. These are the strengths. Identifying weakness. Point out the areas where you struggle and what you find difficult to do. Look at the feedback you receive from others. Be open to feedback and accept your weaknesses without feeling small about it. Look at it as an area of improvement. Always you have to identify your weakness and work on it. Then only it will convert in your strength. Few questions that can help you find out your strengths and weaknesses. How am I different from others? What do I do better than others? What do other people admire in me? What make me stand out? This for the strengths. Where do I worry and struggle? Where, how and why do others perform better than me? What advice for improvement do I often receive from others? These are the questions for finding out your weaknesses. So in this video, we talk about the introduction to self-management, self-management properties which we have to follow, strength and weakness analysis, knowing yourself, strength, weakness of yourself, strength and weakness analysis, example of strength and weakness, identifying strength and weakness, questions that we have to ask ourselves to find out our strength and weakness. Okay, so in next video we will further discuss this chapter. Till then, if you like this video, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon and follow my channel for my next videos. Thank you. Bye bye.